conditions up there with the wind. We talked to Harrison about it a little bit. We saw some kickoffs going different lengths, and obviously the kick at the end.
It was a little different. I listened to Butker's media, and you know, he talked about how the stadium was lower, and he's absolutely right. I mean, that wind was coming over the top and kind of swirling in there. So that first kick that he made was really a great kick, you know, into that wind right there. That was a 47-yarder, and it was right at our line. Our line was 48, and he made that kick, which was huge at that point. Kind of stopped the bleed, and they scored, we scored, and kind of settled everybody down. Very, very, very critical in that game.
In that frame, anything on M&T Bank that you
– Excuse me?
The Raven Stadium that you know about as far from a wind standpoint?
We played there, you know, obviously it was 21. I can't remember exactly. It'll be game to game. We go in and we really evaluate, you know, the day, what happens during that day that you're there. So it's always different.
What do you think about Justin Tucker and Harrison Butker?
They're both great kickers. I mean, obviously, I mean, Harrison is, if he's, you know, I'm kind of biased because he's my guy, but I mean, they're both neck and neck to me, you know, and I think Tucker is outstanding. I mean, he's, when you watch him, he's just so pure in everything he does and consistent and strong, strong leg. I mean, it's just amazing. And he's been doing it for such a long time. So it's, I mean, he's the best. He's good.
Dave, along those lines, we're all talking about Patrick and Lamar, but I mean, from your perspective, are you going to this thinking about Justin and?
I mean, I try to, you know, I'm trying to have Bucker just focus on himself. You know, I mean, you know, if you start thinking about what he's doing, it's there's no sense in that, really. They're not really going against each other, really, in a sense. So, you know, the only time they really see each other is in pregame when they're looking at each other's kicks, you know. So other than that, it's, you know, they both, it's a friendly competition. You know, obviously they look at each other, they admire each other, I'm sure. And I know Bucker does.
You know, the Tyson part of the game, I mean, that whole matchup.
Oh, yeah, it's huge. I mean, you know, this whole thing, John Harbaugh, I worked for, you know, 20 years ago, I worked for John Harbaugh. You know, I was his assistant special teams coach. So, I mean, he taught me a lot. I mean, just about everything, almost everything I know, I learned about special teams when I first started. So, you know, I have a lot of respect for him, and I know how important special teams is to John, you know, and I know what the emphasis they put on it on their football team, whether it's the roster and how much time they practice. And, you know, so all those things, the personnel, the guys they have, the coaches, you know, Chris Horton and Randy Brown, those guys are great coaches, you know. So, you know, we know we got our hands full, and it's, you know, when you put on a tape, you see it. You see how hard the guys are playing. The schemes that they have, you know, it's going to be a great challenge, and it's a game within the game. In this game, you know, a close game could come down to special teams, and you know, it's going to be a great battle.
They gave up a return against the Texans for a touchdown. Out of character for them, or was that just
very out of character? Very out of character, and I'm sure John, it's a thorn in John's side. I guarantee it. You know, there's no question about that, and they're going to work hard not to have that happen again. You know. But yeah, that's a rarity, you know, against that team.
Hey, looking back last week, you know, decided to go forward, fake up on that fake for them.
Yep.
What were you telling your guys? Were you guys expecting that, or?
It's, you know, it was fourth and five at the 30. So, you know, every time you come on the field with your punt return, the first thing you want to do is play defense first, and that's always we always talk about that. We want the ball back, so it's always that. You know, and you heard Bolton as he was coming off the field, watch the fake. And that's every time it's watch the fake, unless it's, you know, fourth and 25 or so. You know what I mean? But anytime it's close like that, you'll hear guys say that. Just a reminder for everybody. And our guys, the six guys that were inside the box did an outstanding job. They saw it. They read it. They didn't get reached. They stopped it. And made it cut back. Leo and Cole Christensen made the tackle. I'm so proud of those guys, the way they rose up and made a play.
How do you assess the job that Richie has been doing? And if Tony were available, would that be open up for a potential like home run shot later, depending on the situation?
Yeah, I mean, that's always a possibility. We're going to go, you know, we're going to stick with Richie. Richie's been our guy. He's at meetings. He knows what's going on. And, you know, and he's been good. I mean, he's been really good. He's making good decisions, and he's solid. And that's what we're looking for right now. You know, injuries or something like that, you might see Tony. You might see Hardman.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.